While scrolling through Instagram and doing your thing, you've probably ran across these quote-unquote models. They're usually going on these, you know, exclusive luxurious trips to Dubai and these other wealthy countries. They really make it seem like they be living the life for real. Well, the truth to that is they do live that life for real. How do these girls afford these exclusive luxurious lifestyles? I mean, is a Fashion Nova and Shane sponsorship really paying that well? Is Fashion Nova really handing out first-class Emirate flights to Dubai? Would you believe me if I told you these modern-day Instagram models are modern day escorts, if not most of them, some of them, or should I say escorts that are really paid well to do certain types of things? Would you believe me if I told you that these modern day escorts, they get pooped on? Here is an IG model called Ocean L. Heimer. Fun fact, this was the same Instagram model that took a picture in first class and pretended to be flying first class. Very unfortunate news for her, she got caught. A fan recognized her on the plane. She was later exposed for really flying economy class. Let's go on a Dubai spree real quick. Let's go search. Let's go find some girls that just can't seem to get enough of that country. So this girl, it seems like she's really living the life for real. So she's also based in Dubai, apparently. And if you guys haven't noticed the pattern here, girls that look like this is typically what these Arab men go for. You know, just the usual plastic, artificial facial features. One thing I've noticed is that it's always these sand pictures. I think that's the code we're going to start to use. Whenever an Instagram model takes a photo at a desert, you know, that's our code to know that, okay, she's up to something, you know. If you really think about it, the locals that live in Dubai, they don't really see the desert as an attraction. They see it as a regular part of their life. So whenever y'all see a desert pic, just tag me in it. That's gonna be our bro code right there. Y'all will know that. Yeah, just tag me in it. I'ma just know exactly why y'all tag me. And that's how we know we got them. Just know a local would not take a picture here because they've seen the desert their whole life. It's nothing new. Definitely does not look like somewhere in America. Oh, look at that. Fun time in Dubai. That's the caption. What's so fun about Dubai, Miller? New home, new lounge set. So this girl does not have a job, but she's somehow affording to buy herself a new home. And what's crazy about this, it's your favorite celebrities that you don't expect are doing the same exact thing. Remember, Ashanti once said, what happens in Dubai stays in Dubai. Meaning anything that was done in Dubai should never be told elsewhere. Well, I mean, I'm making a video on it, so I'm guessing somebody 6ix9ine, the entire Instagram model community, y'all got a rat amongst y'all. Now that I've shown y'all these girls, let's talk about what really happens in Dubai. Dubai Porta Potty. First things first, I want to say shout out to the website Traveling Jezebel. They helped me put this video together. You know, it had a lot of information. I will put the article in the description below. You look around for the top models and the hottest girls you can find. She can post about her luxurious, lavish trip to her thousands of followers. She gets paid $30,000 all paid expenses, 5-star hotel. But what does she need to do in return? Is it taking tons of Lexus and defecating on her chest? Is it doing certain things to make your expensive camel happy? Don't be flabbergasted. Dubai is here. Years ago, a website named Tag the Sponsor, they decided to expose a lot of these girls. This IG model in question, her name was Von Lemberg. I have a commercial offer for you. What exactly? I wish to host you for 4 nights in Moscow in January. You will receive an important gift of money. Round business trip tickets are included. Exactly from 17 till 21. From March, I will be in Dubai, and from tomorrow, in Paris. A lot of trips being taken here. Von Lemberg, how much money? I'm close to Paris now, 1 hour flight. Contact me WhatsApp. She then sent her WhatsApp details. Now we're on WhatsApp. Hi, it's Amin. Good evening. First, I want to say that you look very beautiful. I'm sure we could find a solution. If you would come in Paris Thursday, would be nice. Another model from Russia would be here, but you don't need to have any interactions with her. Mercy, I'm a little sick. Catch a cold. Maybe I will fit on Thursday. How many days you stay in Paris? I don't like another girls. I'm too crazy. The nature of these girls, they're all doing the same job, yet they hate each other. In Paris, I will stay till next Thursday. If you stay the whole week, I thought about $35,000. $35,000 for a whole week. You don't need to interact with the other girl. She has the junior suit. You have a different junior suit too, or staying in mine, which is bigger. But I need specific services from you. I want to make sure you can provide it because I have particular fantasies. She agreed to the $35,000. She then asked, what are the fantasies? Roleplay. You have to act as a very young girl. Okay, for sure, I can provide this. And me young? What else? I want protection, but oral, without pain. I would like to end in your or your face. As you agree, let me know and my assistant will set everything up with tickets. I'm in hotel, however you say that. This is one of those hotels where you spend close to $400 a night. Paris is beautiful. Got her. 5 days, $35,000, and I could come from Saturday. No worries, I want you to be my girlfriend for a few days. And I don't want an escort. I pay like that because I want you to look very, very young. I hope you will not be uncomfortable, but as we stay together, I just need you to use a lollipop, watching cartoon, and being dressed as you were 15 years old. The girl continued. She said she needs cash. Her bank, for some reason, would not allow just $35,000 out of nowhere to be in her bank. But the man had a problem. He said he could not pay in cash because some girls, they had problems leaving the country because they had cash on them. Because it can be hard then for you to leave the country with $35,000 in cash. I can have it before Saturday with no problem, but it takes me time for bank laws over $10,000 for me. No problem. She then sent her passport. This girl is from Ukraine. Flight booking numbers was sent, you know, things like that. You know, a parent of a child, they like to put the kid's hair in a pigtail, and this man asked for a pigtail photo, and she sent it. She complied. She sent a picture of her with the pigtail hairstyle. You know, more compliments were exchanged, more pictures. You are a delicate blonde angel. I just imagine this man while he's typing this. He just has his shirt up and he's just rubbing his stomach. Like, that's what I'm imagining right now. So they talked about the clothes she would be wearing. This man further went on to ask her to wear a pacifier. Yes, also a pacifier. Sad, right? Now, of course, there's been some trolls to where they would DM these IG models. They would act like Arab men just to see to the extent of what these girls would agree to doing. But the screenshot we just read, the man actually sent her a flight information, as you can see. But you know, paying these BBL plastic models is like paying for plastic. Living plastic at that. With that being said, Team Seas is taking on 1 pound of trash out the ocean with every dollar you donate. This video is going to be a fundraiser. Let's save Earth, you feel me? Donate and make our ocean have less plastic. Back to the process. So I made some notes. So if I'm looking to the left, I'm reading off my notes. These men will usually talk back and forth with these girls through emails or DMs, asking if these girls want to go to Dubai or some other country for an all expenses paid trip. Since these girls are usually in the field, they're talking to other girls in the field, so they usually know the drill when they've been DM'd. These guys will offer $5,000 to the largest I've seen, which was like $10,000 for casual, you know what. But the pay goes up, as we've seen in that screenshot, as the fantasies goes up. The more fantasies, the more money you get paid. The more crazy thing you can do, the more bread you get. The girl is then flown out to the UAE, and that is where the sprinkles happen. But you know, while on the trip, these girls will make sure to take several images of them on a yacht, just living the life. And she would be sure to post these pictures on Instagram to flex her lifestyle. You know, a 9 out of a 10, sipping on some Casamigos on a rich Arab man's yacht. Seems like a regular picture to a lot of people, but it's just one of the marketing ploys that they use. Whenever you're on Instagram scrolling, dibbling and dabbling, and you see one of these models that says, for example, the famous one, booking and inquiries in their bio. You ever see booking and inquiries and you see, you're like, what are these girls getting booked for? Do you sing? Do you rap? What exactly are we booking you for? What are you getting booked for? Y'all ever notice that? Booking and inquiries? What does that mean? DM me for booking? That's a real famous one right there. But next time y'all see these girls, just tag me in the photo and, you know, it's gonna be all bro code. I know what's up. After you do that, I know what's up. You know, you don't gotta say nothing, just tag me. Some people may watch this video and think I'm jealous. There's no jealousy here. I don't give a fuck. You feel me? I don't care. What would I even be jealous of? The fact that I'm getting put on? Is it literally getting put on? This is a model right here called Angel Vargas. She had her own wild experience. Unfortunately for her, she was baited by a troll. For how long and what fetishes are you willing to fulfill? You are very beautiful. Thank you very much. I'm pretty open. Are you okay with coprophilia and salmonphilia? Nigga, I didn't even know that was a word. I see salmon. What's that? Shorty, I ain't gonna lie to you. You're not alone. I don't know what that meant either. Coprophilia, I defecate in your chest area. And salmonphilia, you insert a live salmon up my... No, not the salmon. But how much more pay? 25K in total. Bang, that's tempting. Everything is negational. This girl got baited by a troll. This was not no real Arab man. She got baited. All jokes aside, I want you all to keep this as a side note. Women in Dubai can actually get arrested for having affairs outside of marriage. So how do you think the police there will act if one of these models went to the police station and said, yo, I'm getting... and I'm not married. The icing on the cake being the man that's doing it is an Arab rich billionaire. And we all know money runs the world. These men can make these girls poof, Houdini, just like that. testimonials. On an Impulsive podcast, I don't know if you guys have seen Impulsive, Logan Paul runs the podcast. Logan himself and Mike Malak, they realized from their point of view when they were in Dubai that most of these girls, if not some, they have a price.
We're in this place called Cipriani. This is a very spoken about spot in Ibiza, and everybody that like runs these like Super Slutty Snake, shout out Super Slutty Snake, they're always talking about this place. And Stad Guy. Gotta buy the dip so I can go to Chip.
Yep.
Right?
Yep.
So we're at this place called Cipriani, and there are women everywhere, many of them with one man at the table. One man, five women. One man, eight women. Strange. There's so many women at these tables.
Odd, right?
So we have our dinner, and we're hanging out, and the vibe is going way up on this night. It's our first night in Ibiza. And we start looking around. We're like, wow, that's impressive. Wow, that's impressive. Which table are we going to go to talk to try to get girls to come back and like all party and people to come back to party at the hotel? You know what the answer is, George? Every single fucking one of them. Every single girl in that restaurant left the table that they were at to come back to our double penthouse hotel in Ibiza. So we go back with about 60 people. 60 people.
How'd you fit them all in this Uber?
And we walked.
One Uber.
Right. Called feet. Called our feet. It was a flying toboggan. We go to this hotel, to this double penthouse, Logan and another associate of the trip. And we asked that person. You know, we're all just partying, hanging out, listening to music. You know, everybody's enjoying their spirits, having a good time. And we asked that person, hey, man, what's the deal with these girls? Like, what's their deal? Like, they're from all different countries. Like, how did they get here? Who are they with? And he was like, they're all mahi-mahi.
They're all mine?
Mahi-mahi.
A code word that he had been throwing around for working with.
Really makes you think about all these influencers. I've read multiple stories from this, with the one I'll be showing today from Reddit. It was a personal point of view. The person on this Reddit used to do this. Confession of an Instagram model. One of the open secrets about Instagram is that rich men use it as a catalog. So these rich men, they use this as like, okay, I want this, I want that. On four separate occasions with three different men, I was flown, all expenses paid, put up with a 5-star hotel, and compensated between $5,000 and $10,000 a night to hang out with a billionaire or a millionaire. Who found me on Instagram? One to Southern Italy and one to Costa Rica. On one trip to the UAE, my host took me to a party and I ran into four or five models all doing the same thing. This girl even had the audacity to say, please, no PMs from guys looking for pics, my IG account, or you can't afford me. So after her experience, she's still selling the gooch cooch. Oh my god. Yo, you subscribe. I'm out, bro. Y'all be easy. I probably should go to Yeshiva. We went to Ibiza.